Hey everyone, Miggy from Figma here with another Figma tip. One prototyping feature in Figma that is easily overlooked is the ability to prototype with keyboard controls or a physical gamepad. Keyboard and gamepad based navigation is important when thinking about designing for mobility and dexterity limited accessibility. It's also great for making TV and game based interactive prototypes. Moving focus around the screen is different than using a cursor or a touch interaction, so you have to think a little bit differently when planning these prototypes. Here, I have set up a 1920 by 1080 screen and placed some thumbnails. I've given the first one focus. I've set up a thumbnail component with the focus state variant. I've also made a component set to show a row of thumbnails, with each item highlighted for a different screen. And I've placed each variant on their own frame to demonstrate me moving across each thumbnail. Now, let's set up the gamepad interactions. Let's begin by going into prototype mode and going to the first frame, and dragging out an interaction noodle over to the next frame. Let's set the interaction to key or gamepad. For this example, I am using a Nintendo Switch Pro controller that is paired with my MacBook Pro. Select this area and press the gamepad button on your paired controller. Here I'm moving the controller right, and you will see axis 0 fill in the space. This confirms what button was pressed on the gamepad. Let's set that to Smart Animate and set an ease in out transition. Now, let's do that again on the next frame. But first, we're gonna have the left gamepad interaction go back to the previous frame. And now let's set up another gamepad interaction to go to the third frame. You can stack these interactions on the same object. Let's fill in the remainder of the frames and do the same. Now it's all wired up. Let's take a look and see how it works. I'm going to start with the first frame and keep hitting the right key until I reach the end. I can also move all the way back. You can also map other interactions. On this last frame here, I'm mapping the B button on my controller to open up and play an animated GIF. I have the GIF scaled down and invisible on the second to last frame. So when we go to the next frame, it will scale and fade in with the transition. Now let's play that through. I hope you found this tip helpful. Thank you all for watching and happy prototyping.